Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and this is the 2019 iMac. This is the top of the line spec. As you can see here, it's the iMac 27-inch 5K, 3.6 gigahertz 8-core, 64 gigabytes of RAM, and 512 gigabyte SSD with the Vega 48 graphics card with 8 gigabytes of RAM. Now let's unbox the new iMac. And we've got the standard keyboard. Of course, you can change this up. We've got a magic mouse here. And we do have some Apple stickers or documentation we'll take a look at in a moment. And you do get a lightning cable so you can charge your devices. Now inside, we have a little documentation, some Apple stickers, and a microfiber cloth to wipe off the screen. We also have our power plug here. Here's our power plug or power adapter. On the back, we have quite a few ports still, so we still retain the headphone jack and the SD card slot. We have four USB, two Thunderbolt 3, and an Ethernet jack. Where the AC adapter goes, there's a little button. You push that, and above where the AC adapter is a door. Pop the door open, and it reveals four different RAM slots. So if you want to buy the RAM later on or upgrade it, you have that option. Now we'll remove the wrapper that covers the entire screen. You start from behind the display. We'll plug in the AC adapter, plug it into the wall, and then start up the iMac. It's on, and there's no longer a sound from the Mac chime. I don't know why they removed it from all the Macs, but they did, and I do miss it. We're at the welcome screen. We'll click continue, select our keyboard, select our Wi-Fi network, and then we have to agree to the data and privacy. Then we can transfer information from the Mac. I'm not going to do that. I'll set it up as new, and then put in my Apple ID. Once I've put that in, I have to agree to the terms and conditions. Then we'll move on to the next step, and it sets up your iCloud so that you can find it and find my Mac and things like that later on. The next screen has to do with setting it up. I'll use Express Setup and hit Continue. Then also I'll use Files in iCloud. I use that all the time. And then we can choose a light or dark theme. I actually prefer the light theme when working on a Mac. I actually find it kind of depressing to use dark all day, but choose whichever one you want and hit Continue. And then it sets up the Mac and we get to our desktop. Now that everything's set up, I'll get everything installed that we need to benchmark it and to use Final Cut Pro, and we should be good at this point. I believe the Mac is up to date the way it ships, but let's take a look at that as well. At the About screen, you can see it has the latest version of macOS Mojave at version 10.14.4, and again, there's all the specs, 3.6 gigahertz Intel Core i9, 64 gigs of RAM, and the Radeon Pro Vega 48 with 8 gigabytes of RAM. Everything is now set up, and I've waited for the background activity to subside so that we could properly run the benchmarks and not have anything going on in the background. So the first thing I thought we'd take a look at is Geekbench, and Geekbench is a pretty standard benchmark that will give us an idea of what's going on. So let's run the CPU benchmark and see what we get. The Geekbench has completed, and as you can see, the single core score is 5,997, where multi-core is 33,765. Now let's move on to the metal benchmark and see how that one goes. So we'll run the compute benchmark. The metal benchmark completed, and we have a score of 146,514. Now the next thing we'll run is the OpenCL benchmark. So let's just switch it over here and then click Run Compute Benchmark. The OpenCL benchmark completed, and the score is 147,547. Now let's move on to Cinebench. Now the first one we'll run is Cinebench Release 20 or R20 from the App Store, and we'll see how the CPU does on this. Then we'll check out Cinebench R15. Cinebench completed with a CPU score of 3,996. So that puts it just below AMD Ryzen's Threadripper 16 core, which is pretty good. Now we'll move on to Cinebench R15, and that way we can run the CPU and the OpenGL benchmark. So let's go ahead and run the CPU benchmark. The CPU benchmark finished, and you can see it's 1,616. It's basically the same as what we'd expect, right next to another 9900K CPU. Let's move on to OpenGL. The OpenGL benchmark completed, it has a score of 146.51 frames per second, which is quite good and should work well for anyone doing work, but let's see how it handles gaming performance. So we'll use the Heaven benchmark and we'll put everything at ultra and the highest resolution we can and see what kind of frame rate we get. It's running pretty smoothly so far. There is a little bit of choppiness here and there, and it's actually running at about 36 to 37 frames per second, which is okay. It's not phenomenal, but if we take a look in the upper right corner, as the benchmark continues, you'll see now we're in the 40s for frames per second and then the 50s, and depending which part it's at, it can go up or down. So now it's down in the 30s again. So it's running okay, but not phenomenal for any high-end graphics card. Now we'll try the Valley benchmark with the exact same settings and we'll see what it does. Now this is running at about 31 frames per second. It goes up or down depending again on which part of the benchmark test we're at, but it looks okay and most people aren't going to be gaming on their Mac anyway, but I guess you could if you wanted to. Now let's move over to the Final Cut Pro export test. We'll export 4K video, and I'm going to use the exact same file I've used before. This is an iPad Pro 10.5 review I did that's about 10 minutes long or so, and I export it in H.264, and we see how quickly it compresses. So let's go ahead and go to Preferences. I'll show you that rendering is turned off, and then also we'll dump out the generated media files, so we'll get rid of all of those to make sure that it's a fair test compared with the others. So we'll get rid of all the generated media files, and then we'll move on to actually compressing the video here. So let's compress it in a master file, and then once we select next, you'll see that we have H.264 in its fastest quality. It's just how I ran it in the other benchmark tests as well. So we'll do that, we'll hit next. And we'll also start a timer at the same time so that we can get an accurate result. So let's go ahead and hit start and see what we get. Now let's click on status here so we can see how quickly it's finishing. And then also I installed iStat menu so that we can see the temperature at the same time. So this is a little application I like to use that monitors CPU and GPU activity. So you can see there's the CPU there and then the GPU just spiked, and this tells us the temperature as well. So it's really helpful just to see what's going on overall. So let's see how quickly this will compress everything. It's finished exporting and we have a time of 8 minutes and 22 seconds. That's better than real time, whereas the total video was 9 minutes and 56 seconds. So I think that's the best I've ever seen, and we didn't have any thermal throttling or anything like that. This chart shows the exact same test run on other Macs. So we have the 2018 Vega MacBook Pro, 2018 Mac Mini, and the 2017 MacBook Pro. And you'll see the 2019 iMac, if you look in the upper right, the export time was 8 minutes and 22 seconds. The second closest one is 13 minutes and 23 seconds, and then the Mac Mini took 15 minutes and 28 seconds for the exact same project. I also find it much faster than the iMac Pro in my tests that I've done in the past, where this has QuickSync built into the Intel chipset, so it's much faster at exporting H.264 video. During the benchmark test, the fans did spin up a little bit, but not like older iMacs where they were really noisy. It was sort of just a light hum. It wasn't loud at all. And I would say the only thing quieter at this point is the iMac Pro. And the back of the iMac wasn't that warm either, except by the vents where it pushes out the air. And while that's kind of strange that it pushes directly into the arm or the hinge where it holds onto the iMac, it seemed to work okay and stayed cool the entire time. That's it for the 2019 iMac. It had a pretty significant processor and GPU upgrade, and if I had one complaint, I'd say that the bezels are kind of large. I'm used to using very thin bezeled ultra-wide monitors, and some people like the bezels because they're black and the work kind of fades into the background, and you really can't beat the display, but the bezels are really my only complaint, nothing else at all. So I'd say it's a very good value to pick up compared to an iMac Pro, for example. And honestly, I wouldn't buy an iMac Pro at this point. I would buy this configuration. It's definitely the fastest I've used to export video, and it never slowed down while I was working. Let me know what you think about the refreshed iMac in the comments below. Is it something you'd pick up, or did you already pick one up? Also, are you going to wait for a full redesign, or is this one good enough for you? What do you think about those bezels as well? Let me know in the comments below. If you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. If not, the other one's okay too. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.